Hello everyone, I am Jebakripa Roslin. I am happy to welcome you all for yet another video from my channel. Today's video is from the subject financial management, and the topic we are going to see today is investment decision capital budgeting part 5. Yes, already 4 parts available in this topic. All the 4 parts are available in my channel. I have also given the link in the description. If you haven't watched any of the part, I suggest you to first watch that and then continue watch this video. And today we are going to see exclusively about internal rate of return, and this will be the last video in this topic. Before continuing to the video, I am really thankful for the support you are giving for my channel, and also watch this video completely in the end of the video. If you find this video is useful, don't forget to like this video. And I also suggest you to give your valuable comments below and share this video with your friends who may find it useful. And if you are new to my channel, don't forget to subscribe my channel and hit the bell icon so that you get notified whenever I upload a new video. Right, without further delay, let us get into the video. Evaluation criteria, an overview about our topic. After the part 1, in all the other 3 parts, we have seen individually about every single capital budgeting techniques. And we have completed almost everything. Only one thing is left out, that is internal rate of return. And this video, we are going to learn about what is internal rate of return. What is internal rate of return? The internal rate of return, IRR, is the expected compound annual rate of return that will be earned on a project or investment. Suppose we are going to invest on a particular project, we will be getting return from that project. So this internal rate of return is calculating the expected return, percentage of return we are getting from the project. Internal rate of return is a time adjusted technique and covers the disadvantage of traditional technique. While calculating the return from the project, we also take into consideration about the time value of money, and that's why it is a time adjusted technique and it avoids the disadvantages of traditional technique. The disadvantage of traditional technique is it doesn't give importance to time value of money. It is a discount rate at which net present value NPV of a project is zero, right? So let us see, for example, at 10% NPV is 1000 and at 11% NPV is 500 and at 12% NPV is zero, means then IRR is a 12% for a particular project, okay? Right. Internal rate of return formula. So what is the formula for calculating internal rate of return? IRR is equal to base factor plus positive net present value divided by difference in positive and negative net present value into difference in percentage. So to understand the formula, let us take an example. Suppose, let us assume the initial investment of a project is rupees 1 lakh, right? Now, what we are expecting? We are expecting a return which is more than 1 lakh. Only then we are gaining something good from the project. And as IRR consider the time value of money, that is going to be discounted at the different percentage. So IRR is a trial and error method. Suppose when we calculate the time value of money at 10%, the rate of return, that is the present value of the return, is rupees 1,08,000. So NPV is 1,08,000 minus 1 lakh, which is 8,000. So 8,000, which is a positive value, that is 8,000 is above 1 lakh. So it is a positive value. Now what we have to do, if we get a positive value, next we have to try at a higher discount rate. Suppose if we tried at a 12% discount rate, now the present value is 99,000. And a net present value is minus 1000, that is it is 1000 rupees less than the outflow of the, that is the initial investment. Now, so this is what the example. So with this example, we'll understand the formula. First, base factor. What is base factor? Base factor is the 10%, okay, in this case where you get a positive net present value. Next, positive net present value. What is the positive net present value? Okay, the 8000. That is, you're getting a present value return of 1,08,000, which is 8,000 higher than the initial investment. That is the positive net present value. Then, difference in positive and negative net present value. That is the difference. Here is the difference. Okay. So, here in this case, the difference is positive value, net present value is 8,000 and the negative is 1,000. So, the difference is 9,000. And finally, difference in percentage. What is the difference in percentage? The base factor is 10% and the value at which you are getting the negative net present value is 12%. So that is the difference is 10 and 12. The difference is 2%. So here we have to substitute the value as 2%. This is what the concept of internal rate of return and the how to substitute value in the formula. Let us understand the concept with the help of an example. A company has to select one of the following two projects using the internal rate of return method. Suggest which is preferable. Right? So here they have given details about a proposal for a company, that is project A and project B. The cost of project A is 22,000. The cost of project B is 20,000. And they have also given a cash flow for 4 years. Okay, and they have given the expected return for project A and project B in 4 years respectively. Now we have to use IRR method to calculate the internal rate of return. As we know that IRR is a trial method, right, where we try to find out the rate of return at which the project is discounted. So first let us try present value of rupees 1 at 10%. So here I have given a table. The first column indicate the year and the second column cash inflow. And the third column is present value of rupees 1 at 10%. To fill this, we have to look at present value interest factor, and now we are calculating it at 10%. So 10%, we have to note the value, that is the 0.909, 0.826, 0.751 and 0.683. Now let us substitute this value in the problem. 0.909, 0.826, 0.751 and 0.683. Now we have to identify the present value by multiplying the cash inflow and the present value factor for the particular year. So if we multiply for the first year, we are getting 10,908 and the second year 3,304, third year 1,502, fourth year 6,830. So, the total present value is 22,544 and the initial investment for project A is 22,000. So, the net present value is 22,544 minus 22,000, which is 544. Now, the total present value is greater than the initial investment. So, we are getting a positive net present value. Now, what we can do is we can try at a higher percentage. Okay, let us try at 12%. The 12%, the value is 0.893, 0.797, 0.712 and 0.636. Now, with that value, we will calculate for 12%. Okay, I have done the calculation because it is exactly similar. So, first we have entered the present value 0.893, 0.797, 0.712 and 0.636 at 12% discount rate. And when we multiply cash inflow with the present value, we are getting the value of 10,716, 3,188, 1,424, 6,360. When we calculate the total, we are getting a total present value of 21,688, which is less than the initial investment, 22,000. So we are getting a negative net present value, that is 312. Okay, if we calculate a 10%, the net present value is 544, which is positive. And if we calculate a 12%, the net present value is negative, that is minus 312. So our IRR, that is the rate of return, is somewhere between 10% and 12%. To calculate the rate of return, let us substitute the values in the formula. IRR is equal to base factor plus positive net present value divided by difference in positive and negative net present value into difference in percentage. Here the base factor is 10%, because at 10% discount rate we are getting a positive net present value. So 10% is base factor plus positive net present value is 544 divided by difference in positive and negative net present value, which is difference between 544 and minus 312 is 856, and into difference in percentage. Difference in percentage is difference between 10% discount rate and 12% discount rate, which is 2%. So finally we are getting 10%, that is base factor 10% plus 1.27. That means the internal rate of return for project A is 11.27. So this is the similarly we have to calculate for project B. So I have done the calculation. In the project B also, first when we calculate a 10%, we are getting the total present value of 20,134, which is higher than the initial investment 20,000. So we are getting a positive net present value of 134. So again, we are trying at a different higher discount rate, that is 12% discount rate. Now the total present value is 18,948, which is less than the initial investment 20,000. So the net present value is minus 1,052. So if we substitute in the formula, right, so the base factor is 10%, positive net present value is 134 divided by difference in positive and negative net present value is the difference between 134 and minus 1052, which is 1186. And again here the difference between the percentage is 2%, so 10% plus 0.23, which is 10.23%. So as per the IRR in the project A, we are getting a positive net present value, which is around 11 point something, and in the project B we are getting 10.23. so thus internal rate of return of project A is higher as compared to project B. Therefore project A is preferable. Okay, right. Thank you. I hope this video is useful for you to understand the concept of IRR. If you find this video useful, don't forget to like this video and share this video with your friend. Also share your valuable comments below and also subscribe to my channel. Thank you one and all.